Hi.
How's it going?
Good.
Got the cute little house.
Good to see you.
I'm Nick Koparanyan.
And I'm Joanna Koparanyan.
We live in the Kansas City area.
Our family's been coming to Bentonville for about 8 years now, and we love basically everything about it. We love the mountain biking trails. We love the restaurants, the food. We even came one time on Halloween just to trick or treat the old Main Street with our kids.
Our oldest, our son, just finished his freshman year at college. Our daughter's about to be a senior in high school.
So with our kids the age that they are, we're transitioning from being in a suburban home in kind of a big neighborhood to doing something totally different. We just bought this house here in Bentonville near the square. It's small, it just needs to be smart.
It's a nice, charming little bungalow. We're super excited to have a place for our kids to come down and just be outside, enjoy all the things, and really make it our own.
This is it, huh?
This is it.
Wow, there's a lot of overgrowth.
Lots.
A lot of greenery.
It's bigger
here
than the house.
Yeah.
The most important question is, what do we have to spend on this renovation?
We have budgeted $225.
Okay.
Like to come in a little under that if.
Yeah, always.
Grab that. All right. This is it right here.
Here we are. Look at this. Oh my gosh. Once this is all cleaned up, this will be a lot of light. I mean, obviously we are going to have to replace these. These look original, but
yeah,
the size is fantastic. Okay. So let's start with the floor.
I actually love the floors.
That's the thing that we thought was, you know, still cool.
Yeah. I do too.
Yeah, still working.
We agree.
Love this old oak.
Yeah.
The ceiling obviously needs to be replaced. I wonder what's up there. Be nice if we could open it up.
It would be awesome to open it up.
Typically on these houses, this wall right here is your support wall. Like they would run a wall down the middle and then they would have the rafters come up and then they would brace down to the middle.
Yeah. You know,
do you think we can vault this room? Maybe?
I'm sure you can.
Ooh,
like they didn't really have trusses in the 40s. Yeah. They built it all by hand.
A little height. You
know, it's a little low.
Yeah. Okay.
You know, I do think we should have the paint tested in here before we start tearing things up.
Okay.
All right.
Jenny and I have done a house similar to this, literally on the same road. We had some lead paint issues when we bought that house. So I think first thing to do, check the whole house, interior, exterior, windows, you name it, and just hope there's no issues.
Anything you want to see in this space or how will you use this space?
Well, because the house is so small, this is it for us. This is where we live and we have two big dogs.
Okay. So probably open it up as much as you can.
Opening it up as much as you can.
Okay.
All right, what's next?
Bedrooms?
Sure.
Yeah, sure.
But this will just take a minute.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, wow, these are real tiny.
Little.
Small.
Yeah.
Okay.
So you have one bedroom here and then...
The same.
One next door.
Same size. Yeah.
Almost exactly the same.
Yep.
Yeah. Okay. Now you have two kids?
Yes.
Are they going to be living with you here or they're just... You want bedrooms for them? Or
for them.
For when they visit?
Yeah.
So this is it, though. Where are you going to sleep?
Well, there's actually a garage.
Okay, yeah.
On the house. It's a single car garage, but it's nice and deep.
Okay.
And we were wondering if that couldn't be in some sort of a main bedroom or a third bedroom.
Oh, okay.
We don't need fancy anything. Okay. Just a spot, a little private.
Yeah.
If it's possible.
Oh, good. Okay.
Okay. Hopefully. Where's the kitchen?
Yeah.
Let's go.
It's not too far.
It's not too far?
Nothing's too far. Well, surprise, surprise, it's little.
Yeah. Right. That's the theme. Tiny.
It's cute.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's a giant door.
Yeah.
Do you want to keep that door to go out back?
I mean, we want to keep a door to go out back.
Yeah.
Right.
Because eventually what we'd like to do is have extra living space back there.
Yeah. Because, right. I mean, if we can open this wall up some, that's going to help give us some breathing room.
Yeah.
But I don't hate that French door there because if you're going to be going outside, it gives you space.
Yeah.
But if we could close that door off, move that door somewhere, and give you a galley kitchen, if you'd be okay with that, I think it could be really cute in here.
Where would we eat?
We would have to steal space from the living room or create like an outdoor dining space, really. Yeah. That's kind of, I mean, unless we took space from the garage.
That's okay. I like the challenge. I like the challenge.
Okay, so let's look at the garage, because that's the big question mark for the plan here.
Let's do it. Watch your step. This is the garage.
Garage. Okay.
Okay.
Okay, you need closet, bathroom, bedroom, and laundry in this space.
Yes.
Yeah, we would like that.
Should we add dining in here? But I don't know, just size-wise, I don't think we can do that.
If you turn the corner, got rid of that French door, this becomes a hallway. You walk in and you've got mud laundry right here. You can turn and go into a bedroom there. We just have to lay it out the best possible way with the space that we have.
Okay.
Feeling it now. Feeling it. There you go. That was good.
It was not good on my end.
Chase, look at that. food. Jenny Mars.
Oh, wow. Oh, they would love to just leave that exposed.
The side wall going up.
Oh, yeah, so pretty.
I think we should open up the rest of the ceiling. And then we were gonna beam from one side to that middle wall, run the joist right into it, and then just frame the new roof right over the top of that.
Mm-hmm. I like it.
And they get the maximum height out of the ceiling.
Oh, I love it. It'll be a brand new ceiling from the 1940s.
What Joe did in 1940, we're gonna let the world see.
Did good work in the 40s, didn't
we? I know, right?
After 3 weeks, all of the lead has been removed, which added about $7,000 to the Koparanyan's budget. We have good news, though. We have to do nothing on that interior ceiling, so that $7,000 we lost in lead removal, we'll gain some of it back because the ceiling's in such great shape.
And now that the house is down to a shell, there's a lot to be done. Crews are busy framing out new walls, building up the floor in the old garage so it'll be level with the rest of the house, running plumbing for the main bathroom, as well as installing a new heating and air conditioning system. We're putting in all new windows, and outside, we're framing the new roof.
The white quartz countertops are finally here. They're gonna look great in this kitchen. Recessed lighting and a modern ceiling fan are being installed in the main bedroom, while appliances go into the kitchen, and a washer and dryer in the mudroom. We are working on the stone for the patio.
The landscapers are transforming the backyard into an oasis. And we installed a modern slat wall to give privacy and make this patio feel cozy. We're replacing the crumbling concrete on those front steps Joanna was worried about with a charming stone walk-up. It's going to be so adorable. Oh my gosh.
Oh, are you kidding me right now?
Oh my gosh.
Seriously?
This is crazy.
Wow.
How did you do this?
You opened everything up.
Yes.
Everything.
So beautiful. And we were able to open the ceiling. This is the original ceiling. And that's why we put the roof.
This is all original.
Oh, yeah. That's
awesome.
We were able to keep these original.
How about that beam? Was that?
No. That is a new beam that we added. A real beam that we found. So it's new to the house, but it is old.
I just love the detail and the different, like, knots. And
isn't it cool?
Yes.
That height is so nice.
Isn't it nice?
Yeah.
It's amazing. And I'm just like trying to wrap my head around where. I know.
Before, your ceilings were right there. I mean, the bottom of these rafters, it was 4 inches below that.
It's awesome. It is
amazing.
Okay.
So should we check out your kitchen now?
Yeah.
Okay. Kitchen.
Let's go check it out.
Oh my gosh. Oh, I love it. Oh, it is so sweet.
I love it.
It feels like a historic home, but everything is brand new, but it still feels like you're in a little historic cottage somewhere in the countryside.
Nice appliances. I'm super excited to use them.
Yes.
It's so cute. And all this space, like,
it's
a small kitchen, but that's a lot of counter space.
It is, yes. We reoriented everything. This kitchen was a challenge. We were able to really maximize storage. You have storage all around the island. You have seating at the island. You have all the upper cabinets here.
I love it.
It's a very sweet little
home
kitchen.
Run.
Home
Good.
Run. Okay, so should we check out your bedroom? Remember, this used to be the garage.
Yes.
You used to enter over there. We moved the door so you can see why when you go in.
There we go.
Oh my gosh, look at this.
Oh my gosh.
Wow.
Look at it. It is so sweet.
This was the old garage?
Yes. And it's the same, we didn't have to step down.
No step.
No, no step.
Yes. Really like that. I really like that.
And the ceiling still feels nice and tall,
right?
Yeah, absolutely.
And the window seat and storage. I love it.
I'm so glad.
It's just like a hug or something.
Really nice.
Fantastic.
Beautiful. Love the color too. Yep. They did such a nice job. They were so thoughtful.
I think the ceilings are probably my favorite. The fact that they're original and he was able to keep them, it's really just awesome.
Yeah, I would agree.